Welcome back. Graphical method to solve vectors and adding them to find out the resultant is easy and fun. But what about analytical calculations? Let us take a numerical to understand how to solve such vectors to find out the magnitude and direction of the resultant. A vector is well defined when both magnitude and direction of the given vector is known. Let us assume that we have two defined vectors A and B having magnitudes 30 units and 20 units respectively. No units are being mentioned in this problem as vectors can represent anything, like meters for displacement, Newton for force, etc. and so on. Anyways, the units would not affect the calculations in any way. To understand the direction, let us say that the vectors make angles 75 degrees and 15 degrees, both with the horizontal axis. Graphically, by polygon method, we have to bring them together such that one's head is connected to the other's tail. Keep in mind that shifting the vectors would not change the definition of the vector at all. Here, the magnitude will be proportional to the length of the vector and the direction is the angle made with the horizontal. So, while moving the vectors, make sure that the length and angles are unchanged. The resultant vector will be the length of the final side of the polygon and will be directed in this direction. Say that the angle made by two vectors A and B is theta, which is equal to 105 added to 15, giving us a total of 120 degrees. The magnitude of the resultant is obtained by the cosine law, where r equals under root of a squared plus b squared minus twice of a times b times cos of the angle between them, in this case theta, which is 120 degrees. So, substituting the values in this given equation, solving this would give us a resultant of 43.59 units. The direction or the angles can be found out using the sine law for a triangle. Let us say that the angle made here is alpha and the other angle is beta. Using sine law, we can develop a relation which will state that the ratio of the vector to sine of angle made by the other two sides will be constant. So, vector B upon sine of angle alpha will be equal to vector R divided by sine of theta. This should be enough to solve for the value of alpha. Just in case you do not know the magnitude of R and you want to directly solve for alpha, then you can also equate to the ratio of vector A to sine of angle beta. In this case, we know that angle beta is equal to 180 degrees minus theta minus alpha. I will be using the first two ratios to solve for the values of alpha. That would give me alpha equals sine inverse of B sine theta upon R. On substituting the values of B theta and R, I'll be getting the value of alpha equals 23.41 degrees. Now keep in mind that this value alpha is not the direction of this resultant. The value alpha denotes the angle between the resultant and the vector A, as can be seen in the diagram. So to obtain the direction of this resultant vector, we'll have to subtract the value alpha from the angle of the vector A, which will give you 75 minus alpha, that is 75 minus 23.41. You'll get the value of 51.59 for the direction of the resultant vector. This is a very small change in the formula for the parallelogram method as compared to the polygon method. Thanks a lot for watching.